Hey, High Levelers. Welcome back. Rayo Daniel here. In this video, we're going to be talking about a topic that's probably not very exciting and not very sexy. It's going to be talking about the DND, the Do Not Disturb features inside of Highlevel. Right now, there's been a huge change in compliance, both from the SMS, the email side, and so forth, that we need to make sure that as Highlevel users, I want to make sure you understand how to use the DND feature and how the DND feature affects people that may already be currently in your workflows and set up in your system. Before we get started, if you can click on the subscribe button, if you have not subscribed to my channel, I always appreciate your support. And just make sure you hit that bell notification so that you get notified on YouTube whenever we go live a couple times a week. But alrighty, just wanted to do that and let's get into it here. So we're inside of a test account and my goal in this video is to kind of explain some of the things regarding the DND features. I'll just use DND. Do not disturb throughout this particular video, just so that you know. But there's some settings inside of Highlevel that will do this automatically for you. Sometimes if you're not set up on the system a certain way, you'll have to do this manually, and I'll also show you how to do that as well. And then ultimately, how do you make sure that you just stay in compliance from an SMS and then an email and even a phone perspective. So before we get started here, I just want to show you what do I mean by the DND section here. If you haven't actually looked at this before, this is, I'm going to just go into one of our fake user accounts here. And if you go inside of a user account, you'll see that there's this whole area at the bottom right here for DND. This is like do not disturb all channels, but you can also say do not disturb on email, do not disturb text message or call. So just because somebody says do not disturb doesn't mean that they want to be disturbed on all channels. It just means that they might not want to be contacted on certain channels. Like they might want to do email. They might be an email person and do not want text messages or calls. So you can have this selected here. This means do not contact this person at all on any channel. If this is selected, that means this person does not want to receive calls or voicemails from, you know, Highlevel at all on their phone number here. But they, because these are not checked, text messages are okay, emails are okay, just not phone calls. So I want to go over some of these and kind of help you understand how do you keep this updated. And then once a particular contact might have this on their recorded on their contact record, what does that mean if they currently are in a workflow already or a series of workflows? You know, how do you comply? How do you make sure Highlevel isn't going to do anything crazy? So just hang with me here on this video and we'll kind of go over all of that. Now, first things first, I want to go over some of the settings that Highlevel has introduced that can help you out on an automated way of making sure that these DND channels remain in compliance. So inside of the test account here, or your sub account, if you go to settings, under your business profile, if you scroll down here to the bottom, I'm gonna blow this up a little bit here. There are three main areas right here that I wanna make reference to. These are ones that Highlevel has put into your account and they are checked by default, so make sure you check them. Now, these are only if you're using the LC phone system and the LC email system, okay? So make that a point. If you are not using the LC email or LC phone system, then these settings will not, they don't apply to you, okay? But most people, I think a large amount of people are on the phone system and on the LC email system. If that's the case, then these systems will work for you. So notice in here, make SMS compliant by adding an opt-out message. So reply stop to unsubscribe. You can customize this if you want. Make SMS compliant by adding sender information. Again, thanks Digi Global Agency. That's just the name of this test account that I've created for demo purposes. So it does put in there, you know, if you're using the phone system, reply to stop is automatically put in there based upon these settings. And it just says, who is it from? Just to make sure that you remain in SMS compliance. So this is very important that you have these checked if you're using the LC phone system. Now, when these are selected here and somebody replies back on a text message that says stop, then at this point, Highlevel will automatically go into the DND settings and select the text messages do not disturb for that contact record. So Highlevel will do that automatically for you if you're using the LC phone system. Just wanted to let you know. Now, likewise, for email compliance, this right here is, again, another part of the text that's added to the bottom of it to allow people to unsubscribe if you're using the LC email system. Now, if you are and they reply back and they click on the unsubscribe and so forth, then again, Highlevel will handle the DND for the email portion inside of that contact records account. Does that make sense? So these are some of the things I want to show you that are already built in the Highlevel that Highlevel will do for you automatically. However, you being the ethical and morally abrupt agency owner that you are, it's probably going to be in your best interest to just set up some series of automations that will help you out with this automatically. So one of the things that I want to be able to show you here is, just in case you didn't know, and let's just create a new workflow here. So these are some of the emails that we already have. Let's just say this was an email that the contact unsubscribed. So let's just say you come in here, you trigger this email and the events. Somebody came in here and unsubscribed. The event was an unsubscribe event. That's a trigger that you can have inside of a workflow. Well, one of the things you can do here is notice that we have an add tag do not disturb. So some people actually go, I don't have one in this sub account here, but some people actually tag with DND just so that there's a tag on the system so that they know people who have did not want to be disturbed. Now, DND is a generic tag. You might want to create DND text, DND email, DND phone. That way you could be a little bit more specific of which tag that particular person has or what they didn't want. But one of the things that you can do here is if you click on a step and you just simply type in DND, you can see that there is a set contact DND action here that you could select. Now, for this, you can say, I'm going to blow this up a little bit here. So for DND, you can say disable on DND for all channels, which is that top check mark that we looked at. We can DND for specific channels, or if somebody re-opts in, let's just say somebody opted out and they got an opt-out message and they want to opt back in, then you can actually enable this for all channels or enable it for specific channels. So depending upon that, you know, this action can do both. So let's just say for this, if we were texting them and we want a DND for a specific channel, we would click on this and just simply type in what channel they don't want to be contacted with. And we'll just say SMS. Now notice, we can choose any of these that we want, but we're just going to choose the SMS and click save. So this right here, I just wanted to show you, you do have the ability inside of any of your workflows to trigger in case somebody replies back stop from an SMS message. You can use the DND action to change it and set DND for the text. If somebody replies back, if you're not using the LC email system, or even if you are and you want to double check to make sure that their DND settings were set up, then you can simply check, did they click on a trigger link or something, or did they click on the unsubscribe link? What is it? Whatever they do, you can manually go in there and set that DND action for the for the email. Now, the phone is a little bit differently here. Now, phone number is one of those ones where if you get a DND, you could pretty much get, like, maybe somebody texts you. This is where the problem gets into with communications with a particular client. Somebody could call you and say, hey, I keep getting calls from you, these robocalls, I need them to stop. Well, if that's the case, then somebody on your team would have to take that and probably go into the record and manually select the let's just say, I'm just going to do this for an example here, and just I'm going to leave without saving that. But let's just say this is Jane Smith. We're sending them robocalls and using the that type of a voicemail drop on her, and she's just upset. Don't keep doing this to me. And don't contact me again like this. So they call the office, and somebody in the office says, okay, I'm going to come in here and select do not disturb for calls and voicemail settings. So I'm going to do that, and then I'm going to come down here and just make sure that gets saved on the account, and she is good to go. Now Jane Smith will not have, the system will not send out anything for her regarding phone calls or any voicemails. So hopefully at this point I've shown you what Highlevel can do automatically, what you can do in a workflow using the DND action. You could stop that yourself and put that in there. And if you wanted to, just because you do that doesn't mean that you need to stop the user in all workflows. This is a question I do, a little bit more of an advanced question that I do see sometimes on the Highlevel Facebook group, is people are asking, well, if they come in here, let's just say that emails and phone call messages are selected for this particular person. So we'll just assume that's the case. Well, what if they're already in workflows? I mean, this person could be in five different workflows right now. Do you know how much of a pain that's going to be for me to go try to find out what workflow they're in, what step that person is in the workflow? Do I just cancel the workflow? Do I kick them out of all the workflows? And now that, you know, I can't prospect them or potentially nurture them at all? No. No on all cases. You do not have to remove the person from all of your workflows. Okay, you don't have to do that. Because with Highlevel, once you indicate this D&D here, at this level, it doesn't matter what you do in the workflows. Highlevel will not send an email out to somebody who an email is set for D&D. Do you see that? That's the benefit of having a Highlevel platform. So you can keep them in a workflow, and notice that text messages are still allowed. So some of your workflows could send out emails to that person, in which case when Highlevel starts sending out the email, Highlevel will say, oh, email to this person. Ooh. There's a D&D for email on this one. Nope, not going to send an email to this particular person. Goes to the next step, send a text message to this person. The text message doesn't have D&D on it, so Highlevel sends out the text message. But let's just say it's a voicemail drop. You know, this could be an appointment, and you know, a day before the appointment, you drop a voicemail drop. Hey, you know, this is Rayo Daniel. Really looking forward to having our strategy call here tomorrow. Just look forward to speaking with you. Well, if you have a pre-recorded voicemail like that and you want to send that out with a workflow, guess what? Highlevel is not going to do that if this check mark is checked next to calls and voicemails. Highlevel will just skip it. So to answer your question, you don't need to pull somebody out of a workflow, even if there's multiple contact methods inside of that workflow already assigned. So Highlevel will pick the people that it sends an email and phone number to, and then who it calls with voicemail drops based upon these settings. If these settings are not set, then they get everything. If do not disturb on all channels, if the person just really doesn't want to contact you to have them contact at all, then at that point, that is one instance where as an agency owner or even as a business owner, I would simply opt out and use the workflow option to remove from all workflows. So right now, some people, when I say things, they don't exactly know what I'm talking about here. So let me just go back into a particular workflow. So right now, if you were to just choose a workflow, now, one of the options you get right here, if you take a look, is you can remove from a specific workflow or you can remove from all workflows. See, so this one is a nice one. If somebody comes in and, you know, they just said, hey, I don't ever want your company to contact me again, ever. Like, wow, that's pretty extreme, but sometimes it happens. Then they are D&D across all channels. They do not want you to contact them at all. I would remove them from all workflows, probably follow up with the tag, you know, that's like permanent do not, you know, do not contact ever again. But you can use this nice remove from all workflows, and then boom, no matter what workflow they're in, all of them, they get removed from all of them. So there's no reason to send them through any of the automations if they don't want you to contact them ever again, because that person doesn't want to do business with you. So anyway, I hope this makes sense to you. I hope this was a little bit clearer and kind of covered up how to use the D&D feature, how you can follow up and do it yourself, how to use tags with this, and then how to just basically handle compliance on all scales. So guys, again, I want to thank you so much for visiting my channel. If you have not subscribed, please do so. If you know anybody that's interested, please have them subscribe to my channel. I am really looking to grow this channel. I think I have provided a lot of great content for people, and I'm excited to produce some more videos for you in the future. So guys, thanks so much and have a great day. Bye-bye. Hey, if you're interested in learning more about Highlevel, click on the link below regarding my free Highlevel course. It goes over everything that you need to do to get your account created, get it set up, and get it going in about 2 days. I also, if you sign up with Highlevel with me, I do offer a snapshot as well as a client onboarding course that can be used by your client or even used to train your own team to do client onboarding. I want to thank you so much again and have a great day.